a good problem. All right, so first of all, I want to remind you, as we start to talk this morning, what candle we lit today. Who can guess what candle we lit today? You think peace? That's what we, what do you think? You think love? I'm thinking read again. Dyslexia? Well, even this way, that doesn't spell love, so yes. So peace is our candle for today. So I want you to remember that, because we're going to talk about the word comfort. Now in your mind, I want you to imagine comfort to me, let's say, a warm, cozy, soft mattress with your favorite blanket, your favorite pillow, opposed to uncomfort, a mattress made of rocks and maybe a big rock for your head for a pillow. So one comfort, one not. All right, so if you were having a bad day, yes, Luke. What? Okay, you tell me later. Just tell me that later. Okay, so if you would, let's talk about comforting yourself first. If you're having a really bad day, like you had a fight with your friend, you had a test you didn't know about, you ripped a hole in your favorite outfit, you're having a bad day, what would you do to make yourself feel better if you were in charge of it? You love sitting in your coat, that's comfortable. Anybody else have another thing that they like to do? Oh, we got our room full here. What do you got? Eat ice cream. Oh, you are my man. Eat ice cream. I like that. Yes. You like to play Xbox? Yeah, see, that's fine comfort. It might be that you take your favorite blanket and you wrap up and you go to your favorite spot, which might be your favorite chair or a little spot in your room. Or if it was summer, maybe it's a favorite tree you like to climb in. So that might comfort you and make you feel better. Or it might be your favorite food, like he said, have some ice cream. It might be your favorite food makes you feel better. Or you might want to reread one of your favorite books, because that's comforting. It makes you feel good when you reread a favorite book. Or you might want to watch a favorite movie, or listen to your favorite songs. All of those things would comfort you and make you feel better. Now our scripture today, though, talks about comforting others and how we would do that, especially in this season. There was a little story about a girl who was 4 years old. Her name was Morgan, and she was driving with her mom and dad in the car, and she saw some people that were homeless setting up their tent and getting ready to go in there, and it was very cold outside. And she thought how horrible that would be to be out there and be so cold. So she asked her mom if she could go home and give her a favorite blanket and bring it back. And they did. So when she went to preschool that next day, she said to her teacher what she had done. And her teacher said, you know what, let's put out a bin, and anyone who wants to bring a blanket can bring a blanket, and then we can go from there. So people started bringing blankets. And then a news station found out about it, and they advertised it, and more and more and more blankets came. And so they were able to go out and pass out all of these blankets. So this was a way that Morgan found a way to comfort somebody, like they're telling us in the scripture today. And there's ways that we do that individually. We may make a friend feel better by something we say, or we may sit with somebody at lunch who doesn't have someone to sit with, or reach out to somebody. But then there's bigger ways, like we do here at Pilgrim. We have a day that we go and we work at Housing Forward, and we provide the food and the shelter for people to come and stay there that night. There's lots of ways for us to show comfort. And I think the simplest way to show comfort to somebody else, Andrew, can you stand up and be my person? Here. The simplest way to show comfort is to hug somebody. Yeah. That is the simplest way. And you know what? I can hug one person. Close to stand up a second. I can probably hug two people at one time. Your daddy said I understand. I can probably hug three people at one time. Luke, I think we can get you in here too. I can hug four people at one time. but it makes a difference. Yes. Well, as large as the entire world. Because as Sally was reading in the scripture today, we are God's lambs. We all belong to God. And so I want you to think about that. That sometimes comforting somebody sounds big and hard to do, but it can be as simple as that. Let's pray. Dear God, you call us to comfort your people. We will step out and share your love with at least one person this week and show comfort to someone who needs you. And in that way, God, we are sharing your message. Amen.